Attention! Attention! Ladies and gentlemen, attention! There is a herd of killer rabbits headed this way, and we desperately need your help.
Someday a friend may offer you a...
Mondo Diablo.
You'll tell your friend to forget it.
Hello again, and welcome to a post-hospital edition of Mondo Diablo. I am out on reprieve again, and this time hopped up on pills. They make me think funny thoughts. Is that okay? I'm serious, though. This stuff really messes with my mind. I actually refused most of the pain drugs they offered me, which is really crazy, I know, right? Yeah, crazy. One thing about me that's crazy is that I opened my Noah's Ark video back for criticism. You should go check it out on YouTube. It's called Noah's Ark the Horror. Anyway, it's crazy because it's very, very old, like 6 years old, but everyone has something to say about it, and that is absolutely nothing. Seriously. I just sort of got through with a conversation with someone, X is gay or something, who's saying I'm crazy and retarded, and I can't for the life of me get him to explain to me why he thinks that. I asked him 3 times, and then he just called me fat and said I shouldn't celebrate Christmas. And I'm the retarded one. That's so insulting to the retarded who never did anything to anyone. I think he should refrain from comparing them to me because they're probably mostly better people than I am, because I know better.
Thank you. This morning, we'll break down.
This is
To Hell. We'll have more on coming up in just a couple of minutes. Good morning.
Morning, Jizin. History was defeated.
The status quo.
Rand Paul.
I have a mess.
In Arkansas, it's over. Fail.
I believe I'm not working in Washington. I have been a part of the problem.
Pain.
I sinned against God.
Cringeworthy. Yeah. As if.
Well, I personally feel I should have probably abstained.
Damaging it.
I take full responsibility for it. Words.
All right, thanks very much. Press to meet. Good morning to
Good morning, Matt.
Rand Paul is the
orgy of arson.
Keep on trucking.
Out.
Right. Pounce on that. So this was a hold.
It's hard, guys. Thanks very much.
And good morning. The biggest pipe.
This is the first time we've seen this.
We need to clean up.
Well,
thank you very much.
Did all of that.
Yeah. Mark Ann, good morning.
Good morning, everybody. Deadly and decisive action.
Good morning, chaos and violence.
Very hard.
Naked shorts. Just real quick.
Marijuana. Look at this. John Travolta and his wife, Kelly Preston, are abducted, raped, and left for dead. So that is very lovely news.
Wow, yeah, it's wonderful
nice.
News for them.
That really is nice.
Yeah. And they were hit by a vehicle, so it's very nice news for them.
Swallow up. Good morning.
Good morning.
I have worked really hard for my youth.
Baby.
Says there are no other problems.
Thank you very much. And still ahead.
Orgy of arson across the city.
Thank you very much. After your local news.
Listening to the Americans for Truth Hour with your host, Peter LaBarbera. Each week, you'll hear compelling interviews with everyday heroes on the front lines of the culture war. People who put faith and truth above the lies of political correctness.
And I like people who are not afraid of the politically correct culture, as so many believers are. It's a privilege to call you a brother in Christ, Patrick. And I think God is going to use you to... to tell the truth about homosexuality and to answer the lies that are out there.
The scriptures cannot be clearer on the subject of perversion, of homosexuality, let me be clear, and lesbianism. This notion of gay marriage, there's no such thing. Marriage is a union between a man and a woman. And if you redefine it to include anyone else or anything else, then you can't call it a marriage. When you talk to most homosexuals, when you talk to most lesbians, most of them have a story of something that happened to them when they were a child. Many times they can say, I remember when I was 2 years old that I was different. But they don't remember what happened to them when they were one. So many times people can't name their demons. People can't pick their vices, so to speak. But regardless to how they come about this, regardless to how it originates, it's still sin. It's still wrong.
Whereas in the scriptures, it's always talked about as a behavior, right?
It is a behavior. It is not a condition as much as it is a behavior. Now, it is a condition when you consider it from the standpoint of wickedness of soul.
One of the tricks that the pro-homosexual movement is using to mainstream homosexual behavior, and that is they are piggybacking on the Black civil rights movement. It's not even, they don't even hide it anymore. They're constantly saying, oh, you oppose gay marriage. Oh, I bet you also oppose interracial marriage. Well, hey, bans on interracial marriage were wrong, because interracial marriages yield beautiful families. It's a family. Mm-hmm. And there was racism there, but they presume that people who are opposed homosexuality, they presume that they would have been racists. I still catch this all the time.
I think that every African-American ought to be appalled, ought to be angry, and should begin to wave their fists in the air and declare black power and say to the homosexual lobbyists, the homosexual group, how dare you compare your wicked, deviant, immoral, self-destructive, anti-human sexual behavior to our beautiful skin color. Well, I call it anti-human because if everyone practiced it, it would mean the extinction of the human race in a very short period of time. If everybody practiced homosexuality, that would be no human beings left.
That's interesting. If there was an island out there and you had the choice of having one island with normal male female married couples, and then you had this is the whole civilization, the whole human race was dependent upon these islands, and you had another island of two men calling themselves married, it's not hard to see which island you would pick, right?
Oh yeah.
There's not much future in that male homosexual so-called married dominated island.
No, there's no future at all because you're talking about confusion. The God of the Bible made the human sperm. The God of the Bible designed it, and it was not designed to be emptied into an area that is filled with feces. There is nothing for it to germinate with. It will most certainly mean the extinction of the human race. No country is perfect, but by and large, this is the greatest country in the world, man. Most Americans, the American who earns $31,000 a year is a part of the richest 1% in the world. We have poor, fat people. America's poor are the richest poor in the world.
God describes homosexual practice as an abomination. Describe that. What does that word mean, and how does that relate to this whole discussion?
Well, it means that, to put it succinctly, it means that it is awful. King James Version of the Bible in the New Testament describes homosexuality as abusers of themselves with mankind. My belief is that if the medical community would just step forward and just would share with the American people what happens to the male anus, what the problems that homosexuals have with their rectums, the damage that is done, the operations that are needed to sew up their bodies, if you will, and how many of the men don't even give the stitches time to heal before they're back, they're out there practicing that wicked behavior. some are bleeders, men who are not turned off by ingesting the feces of other men. If the truth was told about this deviant behavior, even if you're not a Christian, if you don't believe the Bible, if church has no meaning to you, if just from a pure medical standpoint, if this thing was talked about and we took the pretty, beautiful wrapping papers off of it, you know, and the beautiful label called gay, after all, what could be wrong with being gay? Says to be gay means to be happy and socially accepted and upbeat. If the truth was told, people would literally gag, and no one would want to be in a lifestyle like that. Who wants to practice anything that's going to ultimately lead a grown man to by the time he's in his 40s or 50s or whatnot, having to wear a diaper or a, quote, butt plug, end quote, just to be able to contain the bowels? Is that the anus is not a vagina? God so designed the vagina where the wife can receive her husband and have sexual relations with that man, can even give birth to babies, and her body heal itself and keep going, and there's no problem. But when a man uses his anus as a vagina, he destroys it. He loses the ability over time to control himself. He has to wear a diaper. He deals with incontinence.
This was the Americans for Truth Hour with your host, Peter LaBarbera. Tune in Saturdays at 11 p.m. to hear compelling interviews with everyday heroes on the front lines of the culture war. People who put faith and truth above the lies of political correctness. Stay informed and engaged on the issues of life, marriage, and the God-ordained family. Please stand with them as they work to make America, in the words of President Ronald Reagan, a shining city on the hill. And once again, one nation under God. The Americans for Truth Hour, Saturdays at 11 p.m. on AM 1160.
Your bitch. keep hating, I'm a new one too, huh? See, I remember you when you were the young new face, but you do like to slumber, don't you? Now you boo up too, hun. I'ma ruin you, cunt.
What you want to do when I appear? When I prepare, bitch, the end of your life for there. This shit been mine, mine. What you gonna do when I appear? When I prepare, bitch, the end of your life for there. This shit been mine, mine. This shit been mine, mine. This shit been mine, mine.
Oh, thank you, Bob.
Religious militia.
You know, there's a lot to think about.
Government officials.
Pretty grim.
Paper or plastic? Say the wrong thing, get locked up.
Time to rethink just about everything you do.
Burst into flames across the street from the police station.
We're in even more trouble than I think.
Vertical challenge.
Beautiful outdoor living systems.
The look and feel of traditional gas.
Here's an important message. Penalties will be enforced.
Are you a homeowner? Are you a homeowner? I want to help.
Someone's going to get nothing out of the whole deal.
Forget the prostitute for a minute.
Pocket.
If you want to discover the distinct of Don Francisco,
no purchase necessary.
We're seeing a lot of repeat. We're seeing a lot of repeat.
What's he going to do, my girl?
Not only that, you get laid in the process.
So big or so interconnected or so risky.
I was just thinking, recall.
Everybody's concerned, logically, about their own butt.
But it's what other people say about you that really counts. Oral appliance.
I don't know about you.
Find out how you can create a predictable
pharmaceutical companies. Boy, I've really got a problem. Bob, hey Bob, good morning. There's so many aspects of it, and that's deliberately why I'm trying to bring up so many different aspects of
you can qualify too.
I would agree all day long.
Hi, how you doing? Pastor Steve Anderson. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. Die. Okay. What? Okay. God is death. Okay. Die. We die. Death, hell, fire. Die. Death, hell, liar. So. Okay. Die. Okay. So. Give up and to say anything. Whoever. Now can I come? Really? Okay. God.
He's a liar.
Solicited sex from a male prostitute. David Dreyer had a romantic relationship with a man. James U.S. picked up guys on gay.com. Mark Foley sent sexual messages to male staff. These are the gay homophobes, people in power who once harshly persecuted homosexuals, until it turned out that in fact they are homosexuals. Ted Haggard solicited sex from a male prostitute. Larry Craig, same thing, but it was an undercover cop. Bob Allen, same thing again with an undercover cop. Richard Curtis had sex with a guy in a hotel room.
These are the gay homophobes, people in power who once harshly persecuted homosexuals, until it turned out that in fact they are homosexuals.
Glenn Murphy Jr. gave a guy unwanted fellatio. Mark Busey's gay but works for the anti-gay McCain. Roy Ashburn came out and now advocates for gay rights. George Reeker's got nude massages from a dude from rentboy.com.
These are the gay homophobes, people in power who once harshly persecuted homosexuals, until it turned out that in fact they are homosexuals.
Came out and now advocates for gay rights. Eddie Long was accused but denied and settled out of court. Albert Udulele touched a young preacher. Philip Hinkle paid an 18-year-old boy for a really good time.
These are the gay homophobes, people in power who once harshly persecuted homosexuals, until it turned out that in fact they are homosexuals.
That if you're a homophobe, then you're probably gay, or at least bi.
Did you know that in the Far East, people pay their doctors when they're healthy? When they're sick, they don't have to pay. So basically, they end up paying for what they want, not what they don't want. We got it all ass backwards here. These politicians, they say the same thing over and over and over again. Healthcare decisions should be made by doctors and their patients, not by the government. Well, now I know they're not made by doctors and their patients, or by the government. Read by the fucking insurance companies.
Yet, with all this extra cost, the price is still among the very lowest on the market.
Things go better with food goes better with, fun goes better with, you go better with.
Life is much more fun when you're refreshed. It's a refreshingness.
Food goes better with, fun goes better with, you go better with.
Real life would put extra fun in you and everything you do. So things go better with, 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 things go better with.
think.
It's much more fun when you're refreshed.
No, no,
it's a refreshing scene.
Yet with all this extra fun, the price is still among the very lowest on the market.
What's extra fun in you and everything you do? So things go better when 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 things go better. Things go better with things go better with food goes better with fun goes better with you go better with
life is much more fun when you're refreshed.
It's a refreshingness.
Food goes better with fun goes better with you go better with
real life. What puts extra fun in you and everything you do? So things go better with things go better with things go better with things go better. Things go better when 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 things go better
when
things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better when things go better.
Things go better with, things go better with, things go better with.
Last week, you may remember, we told you good news for cat lovers.
I've always known cat was good.
Yes, cat made with vinegar.
Vinegar?
Cat experts say vinegar is the secret of cat's marvelous flavor.
I never tasted such marvelous flavor.
Nobody could miss the way it brings out the best in cat flavor. So next time you make up your shopping list, you'll say,
cat is wonderful.
And best of all,
thank you.
You get the nonstick crab basket. You get a package of elastic chicken cakes. And one more thing, folks. Of course you're going to get pot. Please return it to us.
My house smells inside.
My favorite thing is that the food comes out.
My husband hates chicken. So I made the chicken the other night, and he's like, chicken.
I really appreciate the fat on the meat.
Another thing that's really nice, you can have a cocktail.
My favorite thing is the fact that it's my family.
Salmon is too dry, a little too soggy. And the family kept saying, Douglas.
I like the oven.
I came home and made my husband chicken with such a wonderful shock.
We just love that machine.
The machine surprised me. In the woods, it's fabulous.
I love the electricity.
Call now and order the all-purpose chicken video and an instructional non-stick platform. Order right now and you'll also get 30 gloves worth $250. Order right now and you'll also get the $30 dual chicken ties for only 400 easy payments of only $19.99 plus SNH. Or send $99.95 plus SNH to Beverly Hills, California.
Bagpipe Benny and Bagpipe Betty bought a big bag of black Baba Vanoush.
Bagpipe Benny and Bagpipe Betty bought a big bag of black Baba Vanoush.
Betty bought a bobble, made a shimmy shammy wobble. Betty bagged a bobble, bleating out the gobble gobble.
Betty bought a bobble, made a shimmy shammy wobble. Betty bagged a bobble, bleating out the gobble gobble.
Betty booked a boat with his buddy in the Balkans.
Betty booked a boat with his buddy in the Balkans.
And Betty and his buddy bundled up a box of baby birds.
And Betty and his buddy bundled up a box of baby birds.
Brought the baby birds to the blueberry bush when a bumblebee bolted bit Bobby on the ball sack.
Brought the baby birds to the blueberry bush when the bumblebee folded in Bobby on the ball sack.
Big blue baboon blowing on a balloon, backing up and bumping off the baobab tree.
Big blue baboon blowing on a balloon, backing up and bumping off the baobab tree.
Baboon roll, cause he landed on his bunghole. Big blue baboon, don't blame me.
Baboon roll, cause he landed on his bunghole. Big blue baboon, don't blame me.
Benny and Betty took a bucket round back, brought a bag full of butter bopping to the burp back a rack.
Benny and Betty took a bucket round back, brought a bag full of butter bopping to the burp back a rack.
Bagpipe Benny and Bagpipe Betty bought a big bag of black Baba Vanoush.
Bagpipe Benny and Bagpipe Betty bought a big bag of black Baba Vanoush.
We didn't wash this thing up. I think we didn't wash this thing up.
It was all washed up.
It was all washed up.
I'm all through with it. I'm washed up with it.
I am no feeble Christ, not me. He hangs in glib delight upon his cross, above my body, lowly me. Christ, forgive, forgive. Holy he holy, he holy. Shit, he forgives. Forgive, forgive. I, me, I vomit for you, Jesu. Christi Christus, puke upon your papal throne. Wrapped you are in the bloody shroud of churlish suicide. Wrapped I am in the bloody cloud of hellish genocide, petulant child. I have suffered for you, where you have never known me. I too must die. Will you be shadowed in the arrogance of my death, your valley truth? What lights pass those pious heights? What passing bells for these in their trucks? For you, Lord, you are the flag bearer of these nations, one against the other that die in the mud. No piety, no deity. Is that your forgiveness? Saint, martyr, goat, Billy. Forgive? Shit, he forgives. He hangs upon his cross in self-righteous judgment. Hangs in crucified delight, nailed to the extent of his vision. His cross, his mantle, his violence, guilt, sin. He would nail my body upon his cross, as if I might have waited for him in the garden, as if I might have perfumed his body, washed those bloody feet. This woman that he seeks, suicide visionary, death rebel, rapist, grave digger, earth mover, life fucker, Jesu, you scooped the pits of Auschwitz. The soil of Treblinka is rich in your guilt, the sorrow of your tradition. Your stupid humility is the crown of thorn we all must wear. For you, master of gore, enigma, stigma, stigmata, errata, eraser. The cross is the mast of our oppression. You fly there, vain flag. You carry it. Wear it on your back, Lord, your back. Enola is your gaiety. Suffer, little children. Suffer in that horror. Hero horror, horror hero, hero shimmer, shimmer hero, hero shimmer, hero shimmer, Hiroshima, Hiroshima. The bodies are your delight. The incandescent flame is the spirit of it. They come to you, Jesu, to you. The nails are the only trinity. Hold them in your corpsey gracelessness, the image that I have had to suffer. These nails at my temple. The cross is the virgin body of womanhood that you defile. In your guilt you turn your back, nailed to that body. Lame ass Jesus calls me sister. There are no words for my contempt. Every woman is a cross in his filthy theology. He turns his back on me in his fear. His vain delight is the pain I bear. Alone he hangs, his choice, alone, alone, his voice, he shares nothing, this Christ, sterile, impotent, fuck-love prophet of death, he is the ultimate pornography, he, hear us, Jesus, you sigh alone in your cock fear, you lie alone in your cunt fear, you cry alone in your woman fear, you die alone in your man fear. Alone, Jesu, alone, in your cock fear, cunt fear, woman fear, man fear, alone in your fear, alone in your fear, alone in your fear, 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 warfare, 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 warfare. Jesus died for his own sins, not mine.
One can keep alive his own soul. A seed shall serve him. It shall be planted to the Lord for the righteous. There shall come to the Lord his righteousness. And the people that shall be born that he hath done this.
Thank you.
Aloha to Allah. Celebrate, radical Muslims. So if you ask me, hello, I'm Tony Perkins. Celebrate radical Muslims away. Not to mention, I don't think no room for Christianity. I don't think RCRadio.org.
And they would hold up the loaves of bread, and they were just as big as put in the bank. And we counted it. Our accountants counted it three times. And I think it was 13,000 or something. By the time we got to the bank, they put it through the counting machine three times. There was $5,000 more than when we went to the bank.
Non-gourmet, awkward, non-amazing, non-stick paper towel. Free. Grabbed and flipped now. Call
696-794-1111-3-1995.
That's the price of one.
¿Dónde estás, arco iris? Queremos ver tus colores. El rosado, el azul, los colores de las flores.
For everything. In fact, we're talking about survivors a while ago. Most studies on survivors show that the atheists die first because
If you don't believe in something supernatural, how can you imagine that you yourself have supernatural abilities enough to survive? So faith in something.
Right. Just get out, get out.
We'll go after her. Thank you, find that contestant.
Oh, Queen of Heaven has no authority over Maryland. No authority. Oh, that power is broken. Every spirit banding together with it comes down in the name of Jesus. Perversion of doctrine, perversion of morals, perversion of ethics in D.C. Corruption in Maryland is coming down in the name of Jesus, and the Queen of Heaven falls in Jesus' name.
Hello, I'm prophetic. I want to address, I got a lot of grief and just getting hammered every day, which I think we are. So if you could do that, that'd be great. Michelle Bachman, this girl really has something on her. And Sarah Palin, this lady really got beat up. But, you know, hammer her on her and felt right away, I am, you know, Dan Quayle. He is a buffoon. And it just wiped his rear. And we should all be that way, but we cannot win with Sarah Palin. I'm excited. Comment on women. I do. I personally do. I'm not ashamed of that. Feelings like that deeply. We're about to have the Mothers Conference. You know, we really need, and I know, you know, I believe honoring the mothers is a real key to abortion. Think about it. More than just a card or flowers, women, thank you. We'll be right back.
Overnight Wednesday night, right around Thursday, coming through on Friday. The mix of Saturday and Sunday was an overnight Monday through the weekend.
Seattle is slow in south north. Seattle bus barn out southeast to northeast State Route 167.
Now, is there magnesium?
Yes, magnesium.
Extra magnesium, yes. With a little magnesium.
Things are just getting started across New England with this latest central Ohio. We can expect Connecticut across much of the east. Sporadic outbreaks of Massachusetts with decreasing Florida now being reported. As we begin to bite, chances are you're going to have some occasional Ohio for just about everybody to deal with.
Here is your habit. For tonight, by tomorrow, it's not the day and the evening, but still mostly Thursday. So more night for Friday by Saturday, and plenty of Saturday night by Sunday from Tampa.
Our record for this date is 1951. Saturday morning with a chance of Saturday night, it'll be plenty of Sunday. Sunday night looking at Monday with a chance of early Monday, the southern Great Lakes will eventually move into the northeast and bring New York City. It'll be Saturday night for Sunday in the afternoon. Sunday night into Monday, Saturday is going to be Monday, which is right about on target for this time of year. We're looking at pretty stable Midwest moving across the middle of next week as we're looking at St. Louis.
Just turn blue. Why?
think these pills are doing me any creative good. They don't serve to ease that much pain, and they don't give me fantastic thoughts. It's like the difference between being a cool person, like my friends, who will just go out in full clown makeup just for the hell of it, and teenagers who go shopping at Hot Topic. Oxycodone is Hot Topic. I think hospitals should pass out joints, I'm serious. Those beds are so thin and you end up vomiting all the time and it hurts your back, so pot would have been 100% better. You know, that's another Hot Topic oxycodone dream I had, that the hospital staff was deliberately putting vomit inducer in my water so I wouldn't eat my lunch and they could sell it to the old man in the next room. Not that the lunches weren't vomit-inducing on their own. It's just that the minute I got home, I wanted a hamburger and fries, and while I was at the hospital, I seriously did not eat anything, yet I vomited every damn day, especially after they shot me up with painkillers. Damn. I thought this stuff was supposed to be really good, but it's not. So disappointing. Why not offer a couple of joints, just to make the place a little bit bearable? Just a thought.